Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty making from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a crystal clear French tip nail. And we're not going to use a tip, we're going to sculpt it out. So by French, I mean that we're going to talk French through the whole video.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Kirsty making for Naio Nails.
Je m'appelle, look at the, where is, how do you say, where is?
Où est le banc?
Où est la piscine? What? See, they're the only words I can remember from school because they are. La plage? What's that?
See.
Où est la plage? We're definitely not going to talk French through the whole of this video. We are going to do a French style nail, which means basically the tip. Everything is sort of on the tip. Okay, so we'll have a smile line in there. This does look really pretty when it is crystal clear, but it's got to be crystal clear to look pretty fabulous. I'm going to fit a sculpting form. I'm going to do an almond-shaped nail because Adam likes that shape nail.
No, I just said that. I haven't seen one in a while.
No, I think you just like it. I mean, I'd like to do a square one.
We'll do a square one.
We're going to do it square.
So she just doesn't care what I say at all.
No. I'm going to prep the nail with the prep product. So we have nail prep dehydrator. I've already removed the surface shine of this nail, as I'm sure you can tell. Two coats of primer. This is the acid-free primer. Right, so I am going to get rid of all the bubbles out of my brush, and I'm going to pick up a bead. I'm not going to bleed it out. I'm not going to bleed it out because if I bleed it out, it will have bubbles in it.
Does it make it clearer as well when there's more?
It'll make it, the clarity will be a lot better if you don't bleed the product out. I'm just butting straight up to the nail and slightly dragging it over. And we're doing a square nail. Be very gentle when you're touching the product. This will reduce the bubbles. It's inevitable that you'll get some bubbles. I'm bleeding the bead out for the nail bed. This colour is soft beige. I bled this bead out because I wanted it to have a lot of colour. I want it to be really opaque. And what we're going to do is create a smile line. So you need to come right where the nail finishes here. On both sides. And we're going to elongate the smile line. Keeping a really sharp brick wall. So this edge here is your brick wall. Right, so I'm going to pinch now. And I'm pinching it now because I want to file the smile line to make it even crisper. And I need it to be set, don't I, to file it. Now, if I don't pinch it now and I just let it all set and then file it, I'm not going to be able to pinch it afterwards. I need to pinch it now before we put the clear on the tip. And I'm going to get a straight file. And you can file your smile line. So this is something that you can do whether you're doing a clear tip or a coloured tip. So once you've laid in your smile line, you can always go back and file it if you need to. If you're not very confident with creating a really neat smile line, then this is a great little trick. So I've just dusted off, but I'm going to take some monomer and just brush that over the top of that clear platform that we've already created. And then now we are going to do the crystal clear edge. I'm going to do that tip. Not going to bleed off the back of the brush, we're going to go straight on. I'm go straight up to the edge of your smile line. Will be a lot wetter than you're probably used to working with. I'm going to let that set now. Now that's dry, I'm going to take off the sculpting foam. I'm going to use an electric file to file this. So I'm just going to take off the bulk where the soft beige and the clear meet. You want to get that nice and crisp, so that's why I'm taking away that bulk. So it is important to have a bit of height on that smile line when you're creating this kind of look. And file the side walls nice and straight. Flatten that free edge off. I'm going to use my round file now to go round the edge. My curved file, I suppose it's not round, it's not a circle, but it is. It's got a rounded edge to it.
A boomerang.
Eighth of moon, boomerang. Thank you, I'll throw it off. I'll come back. Shall we try?
I thought they called that, aren't they?
I think so.
Have
you ever run by him? Shall we throw it and see if it comes back? So, do you like this one best, Dina? You like the boomerang one best?
Yeah.
Is it because it does work when you throw it? Comes back to you. Wouldn't it, that?
Yeah.
You like it, don't you?
Yeah, I love
it. Is that why you like it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Just going to buff over now and make this nice and smooth. Going to wipe over with some pure acetone, and then I'm going to top coat with the Urban Graffiti top coat. I'm going to do the top and underneath. I'm going to do the underneath first. And spin it round. And that's going to add to the effect of it being crystal clear at the tip. Right, popping that in the lamp. Now, what we're going to do is we are going to apply these gorgeous little balls. Micro caviar beads. These tend to go everywhere. See? I'm going to use Mega Gloss to adhere these to the nail. So I'm going to pop some there. I'm going to pick up my stone. I'm going to set that in the lamp. And I'm going to use Mega Gloss here. I'm going to go around the edge of the stone. I'm going to get my balls. So once you're happy with where the balls are, you're going to pop that into the lamp and cure. And what we're going to do, we're going to frame the smile line with the micro beads. So we're going to do one side at a time. I'm going to pop that into the lamp, then I'm going to do exactly the same on the other side. What I'm going to do now is make sure that these stay on by going straight up to them with the Urban Graffiti top coat. Now the Urban Graffiti top coat has a flex, so when these balls bounce with the nail, it's not going to crack the top coat. If you just used, this is what I've found anyway, if you use mega gloss over the top of your balls and then the nail moves, then it may crack. Put that in the lamp. So it's all cured now, and it's all crystal clear, and it's definitely helped by the top coat underneath as well. I'm going to finish with some cuticle oil. Make sure it's nice and clean underneath. French crystal square nail with a bit of bling and some balls. Or oh, caviar, microbeads.
Yeah, that sounds better than balls.
Yeah, I do like calling them balls. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All the products we've used today will be listed below. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. And then we're going to come to a finish in the time.
Sounded a bit French then. No, before that.
I don't know.
Because that's how they sound to me.